Wednesday, April 1st, 2020. Kheran Sector, Kupwara District, North Kashmir. Heavy snow and a harsh winter had confined army units to bases, but unmanned aerial drones, regularly monitoring the line of control, were sending back a constant stream of images to the command center.
Stop! Zoom those images. See those dots? Looks like it's begun. Get me the coordinates.
Sir, we have images that look like infiltrator movement in the Jamagand area in Kheran sector.
The commanding officer did not hesitate.
Send the 8th Jat Regiment. We need to neutralize the threat immediately.
The same afternoon, the Jat unit found a set of at least 4 to 6 on the ground footprints in the snow, not far from the LOC. They followed the trail.
They can't have got far in this heavy snow. Be alert.
Far up on the hill, dodging in between the trees, they saw their target.
There!
A brief firefight ensued around 1300 hours. After which the 5 intruders, to lighten their load, abandoned some of their ammunition bags and escaped out of sight over a hill into a deep gorge. The terrorists were soon isolated, in the north along the line of control and in the south along the Shamshabari Ridge. The villages of Aura, Kumkadi, Zurhuma, Safwali, Batpura, Haihama were quickly cordoned off. At dawn on Thursday, April 2nd, troops from the 41st and 57th Rashtriya Rifles joined the operation. Once again establishing contact with the terrorists at about 16:30 hours, who returned heavy fire before slipping off one by one, jumping over a ledge. The chase continued, with contact established twice more over the next 2 days. The army soon had the terrorists cornered inside a part of Kupwara's dense Zurhama forest, not far from the Jamagand village. To flush them out, late on the night of Saturday, April 4th, two squads of the 4th Parachute Regiment, or a light 4 Para SF battalion, part of the Indian Special Forces that had previously carried out cross-border surgical strikes after the Uri attack, were deployed via Dhruv helicopters for a forward staging to the nearest battalion headquarters and from there to Rangduri, Guguldara and Teen Bahek areas of Jumagand. The aim of the operation was to use the advantage of height, cornering them in a top-down movement. With quadcopter drones giving aerial support, 5 elite paratroopers were airdropped off at a height of 10,000 feet on a hill feature. The squad was led by Subedar Sanjeev Kumar.
Follow these footprint trails.
The commandos followed the trail, keeping a slow, cautious pace. Then around daybreak on Sunday, April 5th, forward members Subedar Sanjeev Kumar, along with paratrooper Amit Kumar and Havaldar Chhatrapal Singh, inadvertently climbed onto a cornice, an overhanging mass of hardened snow at the edge of a mountain precipice, which collapsed under their weight as they went tumbling down into the abyss, falling a full 150 feet onto a frozen mountain stream, and landed right next to where the terrorists had been hiding. Despite the soft snow cushioning their fall, later X-rays showed that the fall had broken several bones in their bodies. Though startled, the terrorists had an advantage as they were hiding and well positioned. As the commandos were still trying to gather themselves, the terrorists opened fire. In the ensuing battle, the terrorists got the first advantage and shot at the three commandos, who were barely 6 feet away. A battle at point-blank range is highly unusual in encounters, which normally take place from a distance. Havildar Amit Kumar sustained 15 bullet injuries, while Subedar Sanjeev and paratrooper Chhatrapal also took heavy fire. Despite their injuries and being out in the open, somehow they managed to kill two of the 5 terrorists before themselves succumbing. Meanwhile, Havaldar Davinder Singh and paratrooper Balkrishnan, seeing their comrades under heavy fire, without caring for their own lives, slid down the slope and into the battle zone. Together, they managed to take down 2 of the 3 remaining terrorists. The The fifth, who fled from the spot, was later killed by troops from the 8th Jat Regiment. Two of the brave injured Indian commandos were airlifted to the military hospital in Srinagar, but unfortunately died that very night. The other three had already perished at the battle site. Let us take a moment to remember our heroes at the border who made the ultimate sacrifice. Four para SF battalion consisted of Subedar Sanjeev Kumar, Himachal Pradesh, paratrooper Balakrishnan, Puid village Kulu Valley, Himachal Pradesh, paratrooper Chhatrapal Singh, Chhawashri village, Junjunu district, Rajasthan, Havaldar Devendra Singh Rana, Rudra Prayag, Uttarakhand, and Havaldar Amit Kumar, Uttarakhand. Every second of the encounter was fortuitously captured by the accompanying quadcopter drones, the footage of which was shown to the entire 4 Para HQ, who felt proud that the squad upheld their reputation as brave fighters.
Jai Hind! Jai Hind!
The martyrs will be posthumously awarded for their bravery. An Operation Randori Bihak will go down in the history books as an inspiring lesson for future probies. 1,197 incidents of cross-border firings by Pakistani troops meant to divert the Indian Army's attention as it pushes in infiltrators have already been reported in the first 3 months of 2020, with March alone seeing as many as 411 violations, a big spike from 267 from March of last year. Soon after this incident, another batch of infiltrators killed 5 more army men at Handwar. Bizbo's Limerick. A salute to our heroes at the front, who are forced to pull off spectacular stunts. To keep us safe, they let no intruder escape and bear the full forces of the attacker's brunt. Subscribe to Bizbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bizbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.